Okay, let's see. I know it's been a while, but I think I might have got my Senna to work. I don't think it was actually my Senna. I think it was the memory card was glitched. But let's see if it actually works, because I don't want to have to keep buying new cameras or new memory cards each time. And I got sick. Girlfriend's sick. I'm sick. The only one that's not sick is the baby. Yeah, I was using something that was cheaper than the G Pro, and it worked and everything. It just it kept starting the recording over each 1 to 5 minutes, depending on what your settings were. Even if you switched it to off, it still had, it basically reset it back to 1 minute. So I worked and worked and worked until I got my Senna to work, so hopefully it's recording. My muffler fell off, the new one as well. So I'm gonna have to get the exhaust pipe checked to see if there is an issue with clipping. Also, if the expand and release that it keeps doing is what's causing these issues. Alright, we'll take the back road. Of course the cops take the back road. Please turn left. Please turn left. Please turn left. I don't even know why I shifted up. and they turned right. Can't do any fun shit when they're going. So, I know everybody hates hearing about politics, but I'm voting Trump. There's big reasons why. Government hates him. The media hates him. They smear campaign him with hate crimes, with racism, and sexism. Hell, if he was sexist, his daughter wouldn't be the top of one of his companies. It's not called sexism, it's called hard work. Whoever works the hardest gets the bigger paycheck in his eyes. Whoever does their job and gets it done. And he's not racist. He's not getting rid of all Mexicans. He's just getting rid of the illegal ones. The ones that are draining the economy. Making them legal citizens doesn't mean they have to pay taxes. And also, I have Mexican friends. I have friends that, you know, came over on boats. They're all here legally because they went through the proper channels. They weren't lazy. They did the hard work for it. And it just sickens me that there are so many entitled little fucktards would think that the world owes them.
Uh-uh.
You can shut the fuck up right now, because nobody owes you anything. You haven't done anything for anyone other than bitch and gripe. Hey, you know what? I worked at a gas station. Well, it wasn't a gas station. It was just a little grocery store. I was getting paid $7.50, $7.55, depended on how much time I actually spent in there. But I worked. I didn't care how little I was getting paid, because I was still 16, 17 years old. If you're 40 years old and you're still flipping burgers, there's something wrong with your life. Get a GED and you can get another type of job other than flipping burgers, because it's not that hard. That's all it takes to flip a burger. You don't need no PhD in burger flipping ethics. I mean, seriously. You're gonna bitch and gripe about how little, I mean, hell, if I got paid $8 just to stock shelves, I was happy. That was riches to me, because you know what? I didn't have to support a family or anything. But if you're still working at a fast food restaurant and you want $15 an hour, grow up, you're gonna get replaced by a machine. And no, the CEOs of all these foundations can't afford it, because, yeah, they might be raking in a lot of money, but that's going into a lot of people's paychecks, not just yours. You're greedy. You don't know economics. Go back to school. Take economics. You'll learn something. I'm not a conservative. I'm not a liberal. I'm a pragmatist. I see a problem. I want people to stop trying to fix something that wasn't broken. The system was never broke. Obama's not your god. He's actually the problem with why everybody's on 8th Central. If you want to know the truth, I would have been glad if he got assassinated. You want to know why? He's not a true president. Hell, Trump makes a better president. And I don't really like him. But you know what? I don't care. He's a lot less of a problem than Hillary, the prisoner, the murderer, the liar, the thief, and Sanders, the idiot, the moron, the one that doesn't even know what economics is. I mean, hell, he spent more money on one little trip for everybody than we have in the whole budget. And all of these other people are getting paid off to basically be politicians. They're owned. Government owns them. Trump isn't owned by the government. He's his own free man. Do we want to be owned by the government? Do we want someone who's owned by the government? No. We want someone who's free enough to do what they need to do to fix what's wrong with the United States. But all these little millennials think that it's okay to go and riot. That's not peaceful protesting. Hell, most of the peaceful protesting is from Trump. I've seen less violence from Trump supporters and Trump himself than I've seen from these peaceful protesters that are going around bashing and hating on Trump and his supporters. I forgot what I was going at. My allergies are kicking in because of all these flowers. And also, I got to pay a little bit more attention, because at this intersection, there's a lot of morons driving. But as I was saying, there's been a lot less hate crime and everything from Trump supporters than there has been from the Sanders and Hillary supporters. And I can tell you without a doubt, the people that support Hillary and Sanders, they're a hypocrite. They want freedom. They want people to stop hating on people. They want people to like blacks. Well, the funny thing is, even BLM wants whites to hate blacks. They want to be segregated. Hell, if Martin Luther King and Martin Luther King Jr. were still alive today, they'd be flipping. they'd be flipping their tops at the fact that every time they hear a black person saying, I want to be segregated. Nah, the whole process of Martin Luther King, yes, I know I'm white, but I'm more Native American than white, so fuck off. I'm not going, there's no such thing as white privilege anything. It's called hard work. I worked, I'm disabled, get over it. I don't even make enough to even cover my own. That disability only gives you, I think, like a maximum of 800. My other car is a brute. That's funny. Hey, look, it's a dealer. I want my drugs, man. Oh, come on, go. Stop taking fucking selfies, bitch. Everybody's got to slam their brakes on right here. The close repairs. Shit. Yeah, that's the sound of a muffler being off. But I did have a Dynatune. It actually runs much better now without that heavy-ass muffler. Oh, God. Got way better gas mileage. I actually had it checked to see if any damage had been done with the clean air going up in, or cool air, or whatever. Not much damage, not more than, actually, it's actually a lot less damage than when it's being pushed back up in there by an exhaust pipe. But, I'm actually kind of hungry. Not a good idea to go grocery shopping when you're hungry. Yeah, I'm still paying off my motorcycle. But, I mean, look at this. I saved my money. I bought me a PS4. Same year it came out. Bought a couple of games after saving up. Bought the PlayStation camera, another controller. I actually have like maybe 3 or 4 controllers. But I saved my money for all that. I saved my money up for an exhaust pipe, which fell off. Oh, it looks like someone got pulled over. Oh yeah, stop on the railroad tracks. That's always smart. Okay, back to what I was going at. Not smart to go grocery shopping when you're hungry. Oh, no, saving. You don't have to be entitled. Or you don't have to claim that you're entitled to get something. Save your money. Stop buying drugs. Stop buying marijuana. You don't need it. It doesn't cure shit. That's all in hell's heads. Hell, if it really did cure, if it really did eat cancer cells, you want to know what's hilarious about cancer cells? That's actually part of your own body. That's grown from you. That's your own cells becoming cancerous. So if marijuana eats cancer cells or destroys cancer cells, where's the logic in the fact that it isn't killing you? I mean, shit. Oh, and if for you church people that are trying to say I cuss too much, you know what's hilarious? Your book was written by a man who claimed that he could talk to God. Just like the Muhammad. I still want to name a pig Muhammad. Oh, and these suicide bombers that are joining up with ISIS and all that shit, guess what? The bombs that y'all suicide with are filled with pig's fat. It enters your body when it explodes. So, yeah, you're not going to wherever you're told you're going. And the funny reality, your women aren't virgins anymore because of all you raping the hell out of them. So, kind of think, who's the virgins? All you suiciders. Good luck with that one. Your logic is flawed. I'm not a Christian. I don't proclaim to be a Christian. I don't proclaim to be a Muslim. I don't proclaim to be an atheist. I'm a spiritualist. I don't see why you gotta hate on Trump, because I take it from both sides. I actually literally see no reason to hate Trump, because he's not doing anything wrong. He's actually speaking some pretty far out there truth. I mean, it's a full football's length worth of truth about how people are becoming so stupid. Illegals don't need to be here. They could have came here legally. It's not that hard. It's not that expensive. They could have gotten a work visa, a 2-year work visa, worked on their citizenship, and bam, citizen. That's it. That's all it takes. You don't have to be lazy. You don't have to cheat the system and not have to work a day in your life and still get paid to live in the United States because you birthed out a child on U.S. soil. I know I'm ranting and everything, but this rant was long overdue. This rant needed to be heard because it's millennials. Millennials are the problem. This upbringing of children that they say, the way they're raising their children is completely stupid. No one's entitled to anything. There's no such thing as white privilege. So everyone that's getting on their high horse saying, I'm entitled. Well, go fuck yourself. No one's entitled to anything, not even the whites, because no one's got privilege. It's the government that's got privilege, and that's it. They're the ones who are instilling all this fear in each other by making everybody hate each other, because they're trying to get people to fight amongst themselves and not see the bullshit they're doing. I mean, look at Obama. Let's bring over more Muslims. Let's bring them all over before anyone can vet them, so that way we can have terrorists in here and they can start screwing people up here, so that way they're more, you know, preoccupied with the fact that they're terrorists here and not able to see what the hell is going on with the government. So, as I was stating, if you think there's white privilege and you think you're entitled, leave the country. Nobody wants you here. Literally. And the fact that you want to change the government for yourself the way you want it, I mean, not the government, but the way that you're trying to change the United States by changing the Constitution, go find a country that already has it that way, and you'll see that you're wrong.